In this segment, we're going to talk about Lagrangian interpolation. I'm going to take an example, and this example will fall under the category of quadratic interpolation. So we are given the following data points for the upward velocity of a rocket as a function of time. Time is given in seconds, velocity is given in meters per second, and the times which are given to us are as follows: 0, 10, 15, 20, 22.5, and 30. And the corresponding velocities are given as 0, 227.04, 362.78, 517.35, 602.97, 901.67. So these are the velocities which are given to us. And we are asked to do Lagrangian interpolation. So we are asked to do quadratic interpolation by using the Lagrangian interpolant form to find the value of velocity at 16. So that's the example statement here. So let's go and look at, see what the solution is. Now, since we are trying to find the value of velocity 16, what that means is that we have to be sure that we choose the closest values to 16. By the same time, those values of time have to bracket this particular point 16. So we're surely going to choose 15 and 20 because those are those bracket 16 the closest. And then we have to make a decision about whether we're going to choose 10 or 22.5. In this case, we're going to choose 10 because 10 is only 6 away in magnitude from 16. And 22.5 is 6.5 away in magnitude from 16. So we're going to choose 10, 15, and 20. So those are the three data points which we're going to choose for conducting the quadratic interpolation. So let's go and see that what we're going to do with this. So we know that according to Lagrangian interpolation that the velocity profile now will be summation I equal to 0 to n. N is 2 because it's a quadratic interpolant. It is of second order polynomial. Times the weighting functions L sub I t times the value of the velocities at the three data points because I equal to 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2, three data points which are chosen. So if we expand this, we're going to get L naught of t, V of t naught, plus L1 of t times V sub t1, plus L2 of t, V sub t2. So that's what the interpolant is going to be. We already know what the velocities at these three data points are. We need to find out what these three weighting functions are so that we can calculate the value of velocity at 16. So based on that, we already know that t naught is 10. The corresponding value of the velocity at t naught is 227.04. We know that t1 is 15. The corresponding value of the velocity at t sub 1 is 362.78. We already know that t sub 2 is 20, and the value of the velocity at t sub 2 is 517.35. So those are the corresponding values of t naught, t sub 1, t sub 2, and the corresponding velocities, which we're going to substitute into this expression, and also in finding out what these three weighting functions are. So let's go and find out each of these weighting functions. Let's go and find L naught of t. So L naught of t is given by the product of j going from 0 to n, where n is 2 here, j not equal to I, so it cannot be same as 0, t minus tj divided by t naught minus tj. Okay, again, I'm going to write down the general formula on the right side here so that you know where it's coming from. It's coming from the general formula for L sub I t, that is for any weighting function L sub I t, is given by the product going of j equal to 0, j not equal to I, and this will be n t minus tj divided by t sub I minus t sub j. And since I is 0, that's why we have t sub 0 here. And since second order polynomial, that's why we have 2 here. And that's how you're generating those these weighting functions throughout. So if you look at this one here, since I is equal to 0, that means that the first term is not going to be written because j is not equal to I. So we're not going to write the terms where j and I are the same. So we'll have to write these products for j equal to 1 and j equal to 2, because this product goes from j equal to 0, 1, 2, and 0 is not written because it's 0 here. So I'll have to substitute for j 1 in the first part, and the second multiple, I'll have to substitute j equal to 2, so t minus t2 divided by t naught minus t2. So that becomes L sub naught t. Let's go for the next step here. L1 of t is equal to now the product of j equal to 0 to 2, j not equal to I. In this case, keep in mind I is 1. T minus tj divided by t sub 1 minus t sub j. So in this case, this will become, j will take the value of 0. So that's what I get from the first term. The second term, I can't write it because j is equal to I, because j is equal to 1. And the third one is j is equal to 2, so it will be t minus t2 divided by t1 minus t2. So that's what L sub 1t will be. And similarly, we want to find L2 of t, which is the second weighting function. And it's going from j equal to 0 to 2 again. J is not equal to I. T minus T sub j divided by T sub 2 minus T sub j. And this is the difference because it's I equal to 2. Again, j will go from 0 to 2. That means j takes the value of 0, 1, and 2. But we're not going to pay attention to j equal to 2 because that's the same value as I. J is not equal to I. So we'll have j equal to 0 and j equal to 1. And that's what we're going to have. So we have been able to find out what all these weighting functions are in terms of the values of t sub naught, t sub 1, and t sub 2, and of course will be a function of the independent variable t. So let's go and write these down, and we'll be in business for finding the value of the velocity at 16. So we already know that the value of the velocity as a function of time is going to be written as L naught of t, v sub t naught plus L1 of t times v sub t1 plus L2 of t times v sub t2. And L naught will be t minus t1 times t minus t2, which we have just derived, times t naught minus t1 times t naught minus t2. So that's L1, sorry, L naught times v sub t naught. The second term is L sub 1. L sub 1 will be t minus t naught times t minus t2. Keep in mind, see what has happening is t minus t naught, t minus t1 is missing because we correspond to 1. And then always the first one will be whatever the I is, t sub 1 minus t naught times t sub 1 minus t sub 2. So again, t sub 1 minus t sub 1 is missing. That's from the j not equal to I part. So that's the way to write down these weighting functions, times v sub t1. Let's try that again. L sub t2 was t minus t naught times t minus t1. And see that how t sub 2 is missing from the top because j is not equal to I, because I is equal to 2 here. And here I is 2, so you're going to start with t2 here and a t2 here, and you're going to subtract every other t which is available to you, which is t naught and t1, but not t2, because j is not equal to I, times the value of the velocity at t sub 2.